You guys have been pulling this crap all season.
Hey,
you go tell them we're ready to play. We're here. We're ready.
Calm down. There's nothing to
calm down.
Hey, man.
Welcome to First Person Defender, where regular people come face to face with unknown attackers. And fight their way out. This is First Person Defender.
Irate parents at a kid's ball game, we hear about it all the time in the news. But what happens when things get violent? All that right now on First Person Defender.
These force-on-force scenarios use training guns that fire non-lethal projectiles.
My name's Charlie Hunter. I'm almost 60 years old. Live in the local area, have all my life. When I was a kid, my father owned the gun, but you know, we didn't really weren't allowed to look at it, touch it, anything. Never really instructed us. I did a little shooting of 22 rifles when I was a kid in Boy Scouts, when I used to do that.
Charlie is a unique participant for First Person Defender. He's not only not really a gun guy, but he also doesn't even have his carry permit yet.
I really haven't had any training with guns. I mean, I had just a slight bit when I took a concealed carry course, but that's not much training in my opinion. That's one thing I know is I need more training.
Charlie put in for First Person Defender because he liked watching the videos. So he has an idea of how to behave. He has an idea of what is successful and what is not successful. Granted, it's a small window. So even though he doesn't think he's trained a little bit. So that's gonna be interesting to see how he performs.
You know, growing up in New Orleans, we've gone down to the French Quarter many times, and you know, if you look down the street and there's no one there and it's dark, don't go that way, you know, right? That's the first option, is avoid trouble. Mm-hmm. But more and more, it seems like it's getting situations where you can't. And it's also troubles coming to areas that you would never have expected it in the past.
The scenario we have set up today is going to be difficult. It's set up in a public area, and just like everyone else, every other scenario, there are always good people, and sometimes good people have a gun.
Charlie expects to watch some baseball with his wife. What happens when a canceled game ends in a deadly encounter?
Sixth grade. Yeah, sixth grade. He's hoping to play.
Hey, everybody. The game was canceled. They sent out a notification a couple hours ago.
What?
It's going to be a rain out.
No. We all showed up. We're here. We're ready to play.
It's not my decision. I'm just here to let you know. I'm just running the facility.
Dude, that's not right.
This has happened so many times, man.
Listen, they call this stuff ahead of time. People complain when they're playing in the rain.
I drove over a freaking hour here. Y'all send a notice earlier? You wait until we get all the way here to call it?
It's a couple hours out. It goes to all the parents on a text message.
That's bull. That's bull, dude.
It's done.
Look at the field. They can play, all right?
It doesn't matter now.
You guys have been pulling this crap all season.
No.
They drug it. They drug the field already.
I know they drug the field.
It's done. This is bull.
Hey,
you go tell them we're ready to play. We're here. We're ready.
Calm down. There's nothing.
There's no calm down.
Hey, man.
There's no calm down. What? You got a knife? You're gonna do something?
Well, you attacked me.
What are you gonna do?
What are you gonna do?
Defend myself. Just go.
Hey, listen.
Hey,
this is bull.
Sit down, man. Just sit down.
Just chill out.
No, I'm not gonna chill out.
Hey, man.
This is bullshit, dude.
Stop.
No.
Hey. Put the gun down. Come on. Put it down.
Hey, who are you?
Hey.
Holy crap.
I'm a cop!
Oh my God, what are you doing?
Index, index, index. How do you feel and what are you thinking?
Thinking that was a horrible scenario. I mean, that was hard to be in that position.
So what happened?
Well,
tell me what you saw.
What I saw, one guy was all upset and getting in the guy who runs the place's face. That guy pulls a knife when he probably shouldn't. I mean, I didn't see a reason to pull a knife at that point, but he did. He goes after Ryan, the other guy pulls and shoots the guy. And I tried to get him, put the gun down. He didn't put the gun down. He turned around at me, so that's when I'm trying to move his gun away from me. And I grabbed his gun, he keeps fighting me. That's when I decided I had to, you know, he's gonna get the gun away from me, so I shot.
So the concession stand owner, was he trying to defend himself?
I don't know. You don't know what was going through his head, but I mean, if I were in this position, there's no way I would have pulled a knife at that point.
But you never know when somebody's going to pull a knife.
Right.
I mean, he could be a little old guy and he doesn't like being touched or pushed around, and that was his first go-to. You didn't do anything when the guy next to you pulled out a gun. When did you move your wife? Before you saw the gun or after?
Before. Right. I moved her when things started kind of heating up. I just wanted to move her out of the way.
Great move, getting your loved ones out of the way.
To be honest with you, if in real life, I probably would have just, I said, got her and would have gone that way and left.
Another great choice, great option. Everybody should think that way. Everybody should think that way. So how come you just stayed there when a gun came out? When you see a gun come out, you're watching him holding a gun. What's going through your mind?
To be honest with you, I was trying to assess what he was going to do because he had the gun in his hand. His guy, who I assumed is his friend, is being threatened with a knife, but he's not like actively jumping in the guy's, he's not drawing down on the guy, he's not pointing at him. So it's kind of like.
It was a tough scenario.
Yeah.
There was a lot going on. I would have liked you to maybe create some distance. I would have maybe liked you to try to protect yourself and assess what's going on. So we're going to go into some training aspects of this. We'll get some shooting done, and then we'll run a scenario again.
Okay.
Okay?
Good.
Crimson Trace is one of the companies that makes this show possible. And really, they're the originators of instinctive activation on guns, lasers on your gun. It can be a real game changer and very helpful for concealed carry. Check out Crimson Trace.
All right, Charlie. So we're sitting here. We think we're going to watch a game,
right,
and it's not going to happen. And some bozo behind us starts a commotion.
Come on!
Yep.
So that stuff starts happening. At that point, man, my hackles are up.
Right.
As soon as I hear someone that's an idiot or can't conform to society, I always get freaked out by that stuff. So. They go down, the pushing and shoving match starts over there.
Right.
And we're looking at it. Yeah. But then this guy, he gets up and he starts going over there. And I'm thinking, at this point, man, I'm watching, I'm thinking, geez, this is bad. You're going to look to me and say, hey, get out of here. So you see the stuff going on and you move me, right?
Right. I move her behind me.
So then now she's over here and you're watching, and you see stuff materializing. As he moves for that, look at him, watch him. What does that say to you? What does that movement say?
I'm pulling a gun.
Something's coming.
Right.
At the very least, something's coming, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'm thinking, Jesus, push me out and say, hey, let's get out of here.
That really would have been my real reaction.
Let's do it.
Let's get out of here.
But don't turn your back to him, because if he...
All right, so I really want to kind of do this, watch what's going
on. That's right. Okay. So if, and I don't know why, you went towards him and got that
pretty
close.
Pretty dumb, right?
Yeah, probably not your best move. I mean, go ahead and pull your gun, Kevin. You got it behind your leg. So if you close the distance because you see this, there are better ways to make a contact shot. And I'm going to show you, okay?
Okay.
So I'm going to leapfrog you.
Okay, so now you're...
I'm going to be you
for a
second.
You're me for a minute.
So I want you to come walk down here, because I want you to watch this.
Okay.
So if I decided I was going to do something stealthy and my gun's out here, if I do decide to grab him and say, hey, drop the gun. Turn your body a little more towards me. I reach for my gun. Okay, I'm not going to do this because this is what happened. You came out and you had your gun out here. As soon as he turned, you guys were in a tug of war over the guns.
Right.
So even if it's here and he reaches, I pull back to here and he reaches for it more, I can make a great shot from here if I'm feeling strong and froggy. But the instant I grab him and I do something like this, drop the gun, and he says,
I'm a cop.
You got any ID on you?
I left it in the truck.
I don't trust you, drop the gun. Maybe.
Right.
What I want you to do is, I want you to make better what you did. Because this, hey, drop the gun. This, was not good. I want you to do just what I did. I want you to trap it, and I want you to go to retention and make a shot. And I'm going to follow with you so we get you in a good position.
Hey, put the gun down. Put the gun down.
Hey,
put the gun down.
Hey.
Right there. But I want you to do it one more time. This time, why would you grab the muzzle?
I don't know.
For
my thought is
I want to try to control his wrist if I can. But you can grab. Yeah. Well,
if I'm doing this, I'm controlling where it's pointing.
Right. You can do that too.
I'm keeping it away from it.
You kind of grabbed it down here, so you can grab the whole thing and start twisting like that.
Right.
Problem is, he can still press the trigger, but it's only going to go off once with my hand on it. All right. Which is good. Malfunction gun is safe.
If it's a real full gun, if I'm holding it and he does squeeze it, is that slide going back?
Slide won't move, but it'll malfunction the gun. But he'll get one round, and you don't want it to go in your foot.
I don't want it going anywhere on me.
Get up there and start dealing with him.
Hey, put the gun down. Put the gun down. Oh. Put the gun down.
Ooh.
Sorry about that, Kevin.
Yeah. That's a great shot. Femoral, artery, pelvic girdle.
Not what I was trying to do, but like I said, I'm not an expert.
That's a great. Oh, you put one on?
Yeah.
Good for you. You had a cup on.
Well, thank God.
All right. So look what you did, though, and how you kept it away from him. The only mistake you made that time was you said, hey, put the gun down before you touched him.
Oh. So
you got to expect somebody to recoil, pull away from you, turn their attention to you. So the element of surprise is really important.
Ruger is a big supporter of First Person Defender. One of their hot guns is the Ruger 5.7, shooting that 5.7 cartridge. It's very low recoil, but a lot of power, and it holds plenty in the magazine too. Check out the Ruger 5.7, you're gonna like it.
Charlie's first scenario, he did something that's very dangerous. He presented his pistol in close quarters, close enough towards the target for someone to actually grab it. He ended up in a fight over two guns. I've talked about retention shooting before, but I want to talk about how do we target during retention shooting. Obviously, retention shooting is from drawn back pistol, elbow back, shoulder tight, and we're usually shooting at the pelvic girdle. When I train people, they have a tendency to rock back because they want to shoot center mass. That's not really the intention of retention shooting. If I'm tied up in close with somebody, I just want the gun to come up out of the holster and back, and I'm targeting the pockets. Because if I target the pocket area, I'm in turn targeting the pelvic region where the structure is. In the middle here, is a lot of soft stuff, and it may not stop the threat. But if we target the pelvis, we can break somebody down at least and put them right down where they need to be, and I can create distance. But I'll also show you how I would target a higher target, because after all, in the scenario, Charlie's down low and the bad guy's up a little higher. So out at the range, what I can simply do is I can load up. I've got two target areas on my target. I can come to retention, and I can come here. I can shoot there. I can move. I don't change the gun. I just change my body. But I can also use my wrist and drop my elbow to go from here to here. A lot of people want to do a rock back. They want to rock and shoot like this. But if I'm already that close to somebody and fighting with them, I don't want to be back on my heels. So next time you're out at the range, think about targeting from retention. Pelvic region, high center chest.
Colt's one of the companies that makes this show possible, and one of the guns that's perfect for concealed carry is the Colt Defender. We appreciate Colt's support. Check them out.
First Person Defender, brought to you by
Crimson Trace. Gundelio.com. And Ruger. Charlie is, once again, anticipating a baseball game. However, things get heated when the game is canceled. Is he able to navigate his way to safety and avoid conflict?
Yeah, we should.
What's that?
I'm gonna go find the ladies' room.
Okay.
We should be good. It'll be good.
Your boy's warm, though. He's been throwing a lot, right?
Yeah, he's been throwing a ton, man. We've been throwing him at home after school a few hours every night. Yeah.
We've been struggling with this past season.
Man, I've been pulling so much time off of work for this.
Hey, guys. I'm sorry, the game's canceled, man.
Canceled?
Are you freaking kidding me?
Fields too wet.
Dude, why would they cancel it? It doesn't even make sense.
I know, but
this has happened how many times this year with no notifications?
Someone's supposed to email you.
Come on.
You guys have got to do a better job of getting us in here.
No, look, they should have sent you an email and all that stuff.
The game's canceled, let's go.
I drive an hour to get here.
Let's go.
Look, I don't know. I don't
you guys
think
you're getting into
you
a fight.
You need to start doing a better job with this.
Stop.
No.
Yo,
you
need to
help. Hey,
we haven't been a problem. What happened?
I got my wife out of there.
Not just her. You got out too.
Well, yeah, but it was getting heated, and I thought a fist fight was going to break out, and somebody's going to fall and get hurt, or somebody's gonna knock me over, and then I'm gonna lose my temper, and it's just best not to be there.
So what were you thinking when she got up to go to the bathroom?
She went to the bathroom. I looked up. I noticed. I saw her walking back. She was talking to some guy. I really don't know who he was, but then he comes in and he says, "Oh, there's not going to be a game. It's been called for rain, you know." And she's still over there. So then it starts getting heated, and I can just see that this could go downhill. Might not, but just. There's not going to be a game, so why am I here anyway? And so she was that way. I went to get towards her and took her out.
I don't even think our role players noticed you slip out.
Good.
I mean, you hooked her up and you guys were gone, and the fight continued back here.
Yeah, and that's not my concern.
So if you could change anything, anything.
Probably nothing, but the only other thing would have been if I could have interjected, hey, everybody calm down, and got everybody to calm down, so nothing happened would have been better. But you can't really, I don't know
anything. Been involved in the mix if you would have tried to calm them down. Well, I'm going to tell you, of all the responses I thought were going to happen, that was not it, okay? So none of us was ready for that, and I have to say it was awesome. You were stealthy in your movements. You were concise. You were clear. You knew exactly what you were doing, and you were gone.
Right.
And we all just stood there like, hey, that was uneventful.
Yeah.
And that's the best way for life to be sometimes.
Absolutely.
Hey, thanks for watching First Person Defender. Did you know there are more ways to follow what Gun Talk's doing? Like GunTalk.com, Gundelio.com, the Gun Talk podcasts, and the Gun Talk email newsletter. Follow us, interact with us. Thanks for watching.